Hello friends, today we are going to talk about tubal testing and what are the methods of tubal testing, how it can be done, what are the benefits and when it should be done. So any lady who wishes to get pregnant, is not getting pregnant after 1 year of marriage, needs to do a tubal testing. If other tests are normal, she has regular cycles and husband is normal, then the next best test is to check the tube. So what are the various methods by which the tube can be checked? One is HSG, also known as hysterosalpingography. Then there is another test called sonosalpingography, and then it can even be checked by laparoscopy. And so what is the difference between all the three? So in hysterosalpingography, a radio-opaque dye is put into the uterus and an x-ray is taken, and this x-ray will tell us whether the tubes are patent or they are blocked. Then in sonosalpingography, normal saline is put inside the uterus and an ultrasound is done to see if the fluid has come out of the tubes into the pouch of Douglas or into the peritoneal cavity. That can be checked by an ultrasound. And then in laparoscopy, a methylene blue dye is put inside the uterus and then the dye is seen from the abdominal cavity whether the dye has come into the peritoneal cavity or not. So out of all the three tests, the best test is hysterosalpingography. It is non-invasive. No incision is given on the body, no cut is given on the body, and a simple x-ray is taken, and it is very, very conclusive. It tells us whether the tubes are open or blocked, whether the uterus cavity is normal, and it even tells us at what point, if there is a blockage, at what point the tubes are blocked. Whereas in sonosalpingography, the tubes are open or the tubes are blocked, we can just know. However, we might not be able to find out whether one side of tube is open or the other side because the fluid moves very fast and sometimes we are not able to make out. And in laparoscopy, of course, laparoscopy is a major procedure. The patient has to undergo anesthesia, and that is not a gold standard if we want to do it just for checking the tube. So for just checking the tubes, we need something which is non-invasive. So why people delay doing HSG? Why there is so much of delay? What is the phobia in the minds of people? And what are the things that they keep on telling us as to this was the reason why, doctor, we were not ready to do the tubal testing? And the first thing is that many people fear that it's a very painful procedure. So because yes, it is a painful procedure, anybody who's, not given anesthesia, a dye is pushed. Yes, at that point of time, there will be a lot of pain. So there are various methods which we can use, like we can give anesthesia, and even HSG can be done under anesthesia. That second reason why people do not do tubal testing is that they feel that if a dye is put, then there can be some complications, some infection can spread in the body, and that might lead to some more harm in the body. So many patients of unexplained infertility and the tubes have yet not been checked. So without checking the tube, the diagnosis of unexplained infertility does not exist. So in our center, we are doing all HSGs under anesthesia. Another benefit of doing HSG under anesthesia is that when the patient is awake and we put the dye inside the uterus, the patient has a lot of pain, and sometimes we get false results if the patient is awake. For example, she tightens her body and the tube where it is attached to the uterus, there is a sphincter and it gets constricted and the dye is unable to pass. So even when the tubes are open, the test tells us that the tubes are blocked. So these kind of false results come only when we do HSG without anesthesia. Another benefit of doing HSG under anesthesia is that if the patient is under anesthesia, we can push in some more dye and try to open the tubes, which might not be done when the patient is not given anesthesia. So when the patient is not under anesthesia, there is a limited amount of dye that the patient will allow because she will have pain, and there will be a limited amount of dye that can be pushed inside the uterus. She will not allow more dye to be pushed, whereas if she is under anesthesia, we can put in a little more dye to try and open the tubes. So it's both diagnostic as well as therapeutic. Means we will be able to find out whether the tubes are open or blocked, and we will also be able to open some of the blocked tubes. So once the report of HSG comes, there are two major diagnoses. That is, one is that the tubes are patent, the other is that the tubes are blocked. Other things that can be seen on HSG is that the tube can be open on one side, closed on another side, or at what level are the tubes blocked, whether they are blocked at the level of where the tube is attached to the uterus or at the distal end, and whether the tubes are otherwise healthy or not. So there are some of the things that we can see and say based on the impression of the tube that we see on HSG. If the tube is dilated, if the tube has some kind of calcified specks on it, So there are various things that can be. So it gives a lot of information to us as to whether this patient has blocked tubes and the tubes are unhealthy also. So there would be no use in trying to open the tubes, and we will like to take the patient directly for IVF rather than trying to fiddle with the tubes. And so HSG is the gold standard test, which is done to find out about the status of the uterine cavity and the tubes. It should preferably be done under anesthesia. And the other methods of tubal testing should be done only if HSG is not available, like sonosalpingography, or if we have to do something else also along with tube testing. So laparoscopy can be done for some other reasons, like we want to remove the polyp or we want to remove a fibroid, and simultaneously we can check the tubes with the help of. So, but for the sake of only testing the tubes, laparoscopy is not a good test because it involves more risks to the patient. So most of the times, people who have done HSG without anesthesia are the ones who spread that scare among other people that, you know, it's a very painful procedure. It is more difficult to be done, more difficult than childbirth, more difficult than any other treatment. And people have that phobia for treatment in subsequent things also. So the best way to go about it is to do HSG under anesthesia. So finally, through this video, we will recapitulate. The first thing is that tubal testing is something which is needed in patients who married for a year and did not get pregnant. Even if the husband is normal and the lady has regular cycles, then the next best test is checking the tubes. And checking the tubes should be best done by hysterosalpingography. And hysterosalpingography, since it's a painful procedure, it is preferably should be done under anesthesia. And if you have any questions related to tubal testing, you can write questions in the comment section. We will like to answer your question. Thank you very much.